What's up, PopNet? Corticon here, and I'm going to bring to you a review. Now, I know what some of y'all are thinking. I just watch some Pop Network and comb my ponies. Oh, really? Corticon again? Really? I mean, when can they find somebody that knows something about superheroes or Transformers? I mean, I'm gonna go find Polygon Dave.
That was creepy. But don't let the age of this release make you switch the channel. This did come out. The packaging says 2011. I think it was like 2010-ish. But it was like a strong, long year that this wasn't on the pegs. Why did I get it? Well, mine that I had, his arm broke. So I never reviewed him, and I figured, hey, I got him in the box. I'm going to review him. And what better place to review him than on the PopNet? So let's do this.
Here's a close-up of the packaging. You can see very nice artwork here on the side of the box. I don't know who the artist is. I do know that on some of these packagings, they put a couple Easter eggs in the background. I don't know if there's an Easter egg in this backdrop, but I know there is in a couple other ones. A little short picture of the poster and the included poster, which is just a joke. Now, this Batman is a DC superhero select sculpt. The body itself is. The head, I think the head, don't quote me because I might be wrong. I think the head comes from the yellow Sinestro Corpse Batman. I don't know. But either way, this is my favorite Batman. Plain and simple. Another thing was that this wave presented with us a Superpowers Mr. Freeze, which I am a massive Superpowers fan. So I showed this guy to Dirt, and in Dirt's words, this looks like something I've been sticking up my bunghole. And I'd have to agree with Dirt, because obviously Dirt is an expert in the objects that are supposed to be utilized for one's bunghole. But enough joking aside, this is my original one. His peg arm broke off here, and you're probably wondering, why the hell does this son of a bitch look so ugly? And to be honest with you, my brand new one I got, his other arm broke. So I tried Frankensteining them and using this peg, and we'll get into that right now. So here's my idea of a perfect Batman figure. Fantastic cape. It's extremely pliable. It's just like really loose plastic. Everything about this guy is just unbelievable. Like I said, it is a superhero select sculpt, which was a prior DCUC line. You can see the smaller abdomen detail. Now, it's really kind of hard to tell, but you can see how his abdomen is skinnier than that guy's abdomen. It's just a little bit, maybe an eighth of an inch. Another fantastic detail not included in the DCUC buck is the ripple effect in the costume. That is a fantastic detail. Not only that, but his vascularity, his muscle definition, everything is just more pronounced. As you can see, he's missing his freaking left arm. Same deal. Got this out of the packaging. You know, it was a little wedged up in there, like glued together almost. And so I threw him in the freezer like I always do. Pulled him out, tried cracking it back and forth, didn't work. Put it under hot water, didn't work. Then end up twisting right off. So I tried putting this pin in and tried to cut it off. And I tried gluing it onto this peg, heated it up, put it in there, let it glue, let it get hard for a day. Came back, glued it in there, and it stayed in there well, but it ended up coming right out. So pretty much a failed debacle. I'm probably just going to glue that, make it pretty much just a stationary arm, and get it in a pose that I'm comfortable with, and just leave it there. But this guy really is just badass. I mean, the bat symbol is sculpted in his chest. He's got the added belt that, you know, when DC tried to revamp the line, they did a couple different things with every character. He's got a nice glossy texture on the boot that you don't see a lot. And not only that, he's got ripple effect in his feet. It's kind of hard to see on camera, and very nice rockers for this kit. Just going to the articulation real quick. It's just on a twist. It's not a ball joint. It's actually, the cape is holding it up for the most part. This is a standard DCUC buck though. Besides that, it's got the ball joint up top, goes in and out. Up top, it's got a bicep twist, single joint at the elbow. The gloves do twist. Very nice abdomen crunch. Waist, the T joint at the leg. You can see how much paint is in this guy. I don't know if it's, you know, the quality was a little low on this, which is kind of a bum deal because it is my favorite Batman. Twist at the thigh, single knee, and then this guy's rocker is seized up too. So I wish I could have opened this guy up and he would have been just badass. And I could say, look at this. He's the greatest Batman figure you'll ever get. You should buy it. But that's two for two, so I can't recommend this guy for nothing. You can see some nice stitching that You don't find a lot of new DCUC sculpts. So this modern age Batman would be an awesome buy if you got it and you had no quality control issues. Well, that brings me in. I'd like to know, do you have this figure? If you do you also share the same types of quality control issues I do? But that's just a quick look at my broken ass Batman modern age. It comes from the Legacy line. And as always, like if you do, sub if you want. I'm Corticon, you're not.